That's easier.
Bernardo, come on.
Higher.
Yeah, I think.
I'll give you that one.
Bernardo Silva, too clever for Alonso. Came to Bernardo Silva, who scores exquisitely.
Hi guys, and welcome to Uncut. Due to obviously everything that's going on in the world, we're stuck in isolation. But I'm happy to announce Uncut is still going, and we are joined by Manchester City's Bernardo Silva. Bernardo, how are you?
Very good, and you?
Yeah, I am good, thank you. Are you managing to keep fit?
I'm trying to do my best. So I was in Portugal for more than a month, and there it was a bit easier because I was in the countryside, and I had a lot of places to go and use my bicycle, run a bit, play tennis, even swim. Now I'm back to Manchester, and I've been trying to work a little bit in the city center, just run, do some abs, some push-ups, try to keep as fit as possible.
Well, you strike me as a player who's very fit anyway, so I imagine you'll be fine. So the first one is shooting.
Shooting Cristiano.
Okay. What makes his shooting so good?
That's easier. I think he's one of the best finishers, if not the best ever. It's in my opinion his best quality. The way he moves inside the box and the way he finishes, left foot, right foot, head, is just unstoppable inside the box.
Cristiano Ronaldo, let's fly! Scores the goal. Stunning, absolutely stunning from the Portuguese international.
The next one is pace.
I have to go with him again. I have to go with him. No, because he's so fast. He's so fast. Nani was good as well.
Yeah, Nani was very quick.
Because I'll change, so I don't put Cristiano both.
Okay.
I'll put Nani. I think yeah, very fast as well, and a great player for Man United at the time.
Ronaldo calling for it on the far side, but he's gone for it! And how? What about that?
So, moving on, we'll go to defending.
Easy one, Carvalho, Ricardo Carvalho, played for Chelsea. For me, of course, I'm only 25 years old, but the best defender that Portugal has ever seen. I had the pleasure to play with him in Monaco, and unbelievable player.
Challenge from Ricardo Carvalho.
I think him with John Terry by his side, I think that those two together were one of the best defensive duos that the Premier League has seen, no doubt about that one.
And Ricardo Carvalho, as prompt and as alert as ever.
Next is dribbling. Hey, it's okay, Bernardo, to say yourself here. I think you're an excellent dribbler.
Dribbling, I'm going with Bernardo Silva. No, I won't choose the same ones. I could go again with Nani or Cristiano. Yeah. So I'm going with me for this one.
Bernardo Silva, too clever for Alonso.
Everybody watches the way Man City plays. You've a great flow with the ball and how it moves around. But when you get the ball and you're trying to dribble past them, what are you thinking?
It's more and more difficult because most teams now against us, they play very
low block. Yeah.
Yeah. And 11 players behind the ball, so we have to be very patient. When you find the space, when you feel the other team is tired, your defender, in my case, when I play in the right wing, when I feel the left back is tired, I just try and go and put some pressure on him, see the way he reacts, if he gives me more space. Some defenders give me more space than others. Sometimes you just think it's better to pass. I think it's the feeling at the moment. I cannot explain it.
For me, I love watching the way you play, Bernardo, the way you dribble, the way you pass the ball, the way you move, especially in the Man City team. Like, a lot of people are going to be watching that and, you know, they're going to be asking themselves, how can I be the next Bernardo Silva?
I think my best advice, the best advice that I can give, especially to young kids, is try and be serious in what you do, but enjoy football, have fun. Because when you're free, when you have fun, everything is easier and everything will go better.
So we'll move on to passing.
I could go with Ruben Neves or I could go with Deco.
And Ruben Neves!
But nobody anywhere near Deco. There is a terrific finish.
Raul Morales.
Raul Meireles, yeah.
Taking a more focal role, Meireles! Goodness me!
Even Bruno Fernandes just arrived.
But... yes, of course.
Bruno Fernandes! Oh! He's a special player.
But yeah, I'm going with Moutinho. I'm going with João.
So tell me about his passing.
I think João, I played with him in Monaco as well. And he was a mentor to me. So I think he was the player that I learned the most in my career. And his passing, it's outstanding.
To João Moutinho!
Yeah, Bernardo, I agree with you. He is a wonderful player. Next up, physical.
I'm going with Cancelo, even though he looks skinny and not very powerful. He's fast, his legs are strong, a quite controversial one, but I'm going with him.
Now, I want you to rate your player out of 99.
Oof, that's a very good player, huh?
Okay.
The one, the player I built, I think it's at least like a 94. 95.
Oh no, Bernardo, come on, 97, 98.
Higher.
Yes, definitely.
He's a 97, is he? A 97.
Yeah, you've 97. Got the best of everything.
I've got the best of everything, yeah, it's true.
So the next thing we're going to move on to is you've scored 18 Premier League goals. Mm-hmm. I want you to pick your five best.
The one that means the most to me, Manchester United at Old Trafford last season.
Bernardo Silva scores!
Because it was one of the last games of this season. We needed to win that game, and it was the 1-0 that game, that goal.
Yeah, yeah.
So very important. And that's the most important goal I scored. Then I like the one against Arsenal as well at the Emirates 2 seasons ago.
Came to Bernardo Silva, who scores exquisitely.
I like the one, even though it was not a very nice goal, I like the one against Chelsea 2 seasons ago, because we won 1-0 and I scored that one.
What was the goal like, even though you didn't like it?
I think it was with the shin pad. It was an ugly goal. ugly goal, but those are the best. Those are the best. If the ball hits the net, it's a goal. David Silva crosses from the left side, and I was on the far post, and I just tried to kick the ball, and the ball hits my shin pad, everything. I don't know if I scored with my shin pad, with my ankle. I don't even remember. I remember a nice goal. I think it was, I don't know who crossed the ball, but it was with my head like this. And I think it was, I flicked it on. I like that one.
I'm sure as an excellent footballer you were, there's not too many Bernardo Silva headed goals.
Okay. I'll give you that one.
Yeah.
I'll give you that one. And my last one, I'm going with Burnley.
Okay.
Burnley at home. I like this one because it was kind of funny. All the fans and the players were complaining about an eventual penalty. The referee didn't whistle, but it was, for us, it was a clear penalty, so everyone stopped. David Silva kept going. He crosses the ball, everyone stopped. I shoot, goal. The referee didn't whistle penalty, but it was a goal. Then we realized it was a goal, and we start celebrating. Burnley players start complaining. It was kind of a mess, so it was a funny goal.
What's your fashion like? Would you say you're fashionable amongst your teammates?
Well, they don't think so. They think I'm terrible.
Really?
They think I'm terrible. I think I'm fine. I think I'm good, but different styles. So yeah. I have like a more simple style. I like to wear shirts. I like a nice jacket, simple shoes, white sneakers. But yeah, I think I have a good style. They don't agree with me, but yeah.
I'm like you. I'm very simple, plain, you know, keep my nice shirt, nice t-shirt, nice jacket, yeah. You know. What is your joke telling like?
Joke telling. Well, in English, it's not as easy to tell jokes, but I think I'm a funny guy, especially when I'm with my teammates, with my friends, when I'm more relaxed. And yeah, I just like to have fun. I don't mind people joking around and telling jokes about me, as long as we can go both ways. So they do to me, I do to them. But yeah, I like to enjoy life and have fun.
Rapping?
No, terrible.
No?
No.
What kind of music?
Not my thing. What kind of music? Okay, a bit of everything, but I'll go with indie rock, jazz, soul, blues, Portuguese music as well, Brazilian music, bossa nova, it's like a kind of jazz, samba. Okay. But a bit of everything. Everything that's good, I like.
What's your dancing like? Because you like all this jazz and blues music. Can you dance?
I'm not a very good dancer, I have to admit. But I try to make my moves, and I give my best. That's everything that we're asked.
Ah, okay. Well, that's all that anyone can ask, is that you give your best. What is your cooking like?
My cooking. I think my cooking is actually quite good. So in August, it's 6 years that I've lived abroad, and I have to cook for myself. And now quarantine, I have to do every day, lunch, breakfast, dinner. So my cooking skills are fine, are good, I think so.
And the last one is your FIFA ability.
My FIFA ability.
Are you good at FIFA?
I'll have to be very honest with you. I was quite good a few years ago, and when I say a few years ago, it was like 10 years ago. I play sometimes at the training ground when they're there and they're playing, but I'm not a very good player. I'm not a very good player.
And who do you be playing against?
I don't know. I think the ones that play the most is Riyad, Raheem Sterling, Zinchenko, Mendy. I'd probably try to play against Gabriel as well. I'd probably try to play against John. He doesn't look like a very good player, so I'll go with him. I think it would be a fair fight.
Do you lose or do you win?
I mostly lose, I have to admit it. I mostly lose.
I wanted to see if you'd be honest and say, you know, because everybody always says, I'm very good at FIFA.
No,
I always win.
I always win. No. Yeah. I have to be honest. I lose most of the times. I lose. Sometimes I get lucky, though, when I win a game or two. A game out of 10.
Okay. Well, maybe we can help you get better, okay? But anyway, Bernardo, that is everything. I'd like to thank you so much for, you know, taking some time. I hope you stay safe and sound. And to everyone else that is watching, stay safe and sound and look after yourselves. This won't be forever, but big thank you to everyone.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much, guys, and stay healthy. And hopefully see you soon on the pitch. Bye-bye.
Good one.